Good morning. I am Kevin Price. Delighted to be with you on this Monday morning, talking to you about you and your business. We've got a lot to talk about. Every Monday, I bring my good friend on, Steve Beeman. He's with the Society for the Advancement of Financial Education, an organization that he and I are both involved in, trying to really build healthy approaches, better approaches to financial challenges that are out there for our business owners in particular, but also for individuals in general. We're big on empowerment. And Steve, before we introduce our guests that we have, another person who's being hit by incredible actions by the government that you have to sit there and scratch your head as to wonder what in the world is the government doing. Before we introduce him, why don't you tell us a little bit more about the society?
Well, good morning, Kevin. As it is every Monday, it's great to be on the program, and a happy beginning of the week to everybody. Well, the society is out to empower folks, as you say, with the knowledge they need to thrive and prosper in this new decade, in this new century. We had a great week last week. We spoke to over 100 people in Illinois at the Huntley meeting, and we talked about empowering them with some new ideas. We talked about the impact of graphene that's coming about in the manufacturing sector, as well as 3D printing. So we're offering some optimistic views for people to restore a little hope in this country.
Well, we can use a little bit of that. Now, Gary responded to a request that we had through a media service that I utilize, Gary Castell, and he's with a company called SHIELD.com. And before you kind of tell us your story, and of course, welcome, Gary, well, tell us a little bit about your company.
Good morning. The Sill Shield is a windowsill protector for pet owners. I was a design engineer in the plastics industry for many years, and have been a dog owner for many years. And my dogs were always barking out the window and always tearing up my windowsills. And I just knew that I couldn't be the only one to have this problem. Mm-hmm. And I looked and looked, could not find any product, and came out with one myself in 2006.
Well, that sounds interesting, and I encourage people to learn more about that. If you got a dog and your dog is driving you nuts, you know, with that kind of activity, you definitely want to check that out. You see, I thought you were going to take your plastic engineering background and love for dog to create plastic dogs, but you know what? I think what you did is probably far more innovative.
Well, you know, behavioral problems are something that most dog owners deal with, and certain things you can train your dog out of, and other things, you know, I tried everything. My father was actually a professional trainer back in the 70s, and I tried everything.
Yeah.
But instincts prevail. When a good squirrel goes by the window, my dog's going to let it know whose house this is.
There you go. So, Gary, tell us your horror story. What has government done to, quote, help your business?
Nothing. First, let me start out by saying it is a one-man business, one man and a couple of dogs. When I first incorporated, I constantly got letters from, I'm in New York State, from the New York State because I didn't have compensation for my employees, compensation insurance, mm-hmm. workers' comp. And I kept telling them, I don't have any workers. And they'd say, oh, we understand, and the next week I would get a fine. And I went through months of that before somehow I was faxing things, calling, and in quite a bit of a panic. When you first start out a business, the last thing you need is a $5,000 fine. Someone realized what I had been saying for months, and it stopped. My latest annoyance is something that annoys a lot of people, but for me, it's really critical. Mm-hmm. I was called to jury duty, and I tried explaining that I am a one-man business. If I am not here, there is no business. Now, I get raw materials. I have 30 days to pay for those raw materials. My suppliers don't care that I am getting called to jury duty. I've got to bring my materials in, manufacture my products, get them out the door, get the money back to the suppliers in 30 days. Even an interruption of a week or two could put me into bankruptcy.
Yeah. So let's talk about the first one, because the second one is a challenge that everyone has. And frankly, I kind of understand the challenge with the government, because everyone kind of has a their own reason as to why they don't think they should have to do jury duty. And I understand yours. The first one is the one that makes me more alarmed, you know, from a consequence perspective. And I want to get Steve Beamon to chime in on it.
Yeah. Just, I think, Gary, as you talk about this, one of the issues facing the entrepreneurial spirit in America is this overload of bureaucracy. And I think Gary brings up a terrific issue, and that is when a guy starts a company, a man or a woman sits down and says, I have a great idea, I'm going to start this. They immediately get hit with unemployment, state unemployment, federal unemployment, workers' comp, and all this bureaucracy they don't know how to deal with. And Gary brings up such a critical point on the cost of that. It's not just the direct fines, but it's the time consumption of trying to comply with all of these bureaucratic regulations that just makes it at the margin almost not worth starting a business.
Mm-hmm. May I interject one more thing?
Yeah.
As a result of that, I have ADP do my payroll. I pay myself one paycheck a month, but I am so terrified of making some kind of mistake and winding up back and going through it all again, that I actually pay ADP to do my payroll.
Where are you? What part of the country are you in? Sounds like a California deal.
No, I am in Greenwood Lake, New York. It's a small town about 50 miles north of Manhattan.
Yeah, it's probably... I'm sorry?
Even worse than California.
Yeah, I was going to say, it might as well be California then. Yeah, it's probably even worse. That's incredible. And so that's additional cost, additional burden.
$100 a year to have ADP do my payroll.
How much?
A couple of hundred dollars a year.
For one person to have their payroll done, it's ludicrous.
Yeah. Well, and it's also, I think people need to understand, if they're going to run a small business, those employment taxes, if you don't pay them, your corporation won't shield you from that. That is a personal liability. So, you know, even though you're using those payroll services, you've got to make sure you pay those employment taxes or the government's going to come at you personally.
Yeah, it's really, really unbelievable. And it's the kind of stories we're talking about. And here, you know, this guest here, he's working, he's trying to pursue the American dream, he's not living on the dole, and even in a one-man solopreneur operation, the government's trying to essentially shut him down before he gets started. To me, it's just one of the tragedies that are out there. And Gary, I thank you for spending time telling us your story.
My pleasure.
I appreciate it very much. Give that website one more time before we let you go.
It's www.silshield.com. That's SILLSHIELD.
Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you.
When we come back, I'm going to spend some time talking to my good friend Steve about what's happening out there in the political, business, economic front, things you need to know, the stuff we talk about every Tuesday right here on The Price of Business. Do want to remind you to check us out over at priceofbusiness.com, where the show never ends. While you're there, like it on Facebook, follow it on Twitter. Stay tuned for more.